See, I remember being the company is, if you find yourself having to write off 17 billion shillings and you are not standing, it will hit one, your profit, and two, it will certainly affect the composition of your capital.
The biggest cause of the loss, which of course eroded their capital position, were two things. One, that 17 billion shillings of a deferred tax benefit, which had to be written off. When we are computing capital, we subtract any loans to related entities. Unfortunately, in the computation of capital, that money must be deducted. Because see, as a bank, and you even see that the problems that Crane Bank had, Greenland, ICB zone. Inside the lending tends to be the source of all problems.
When you become undercapitalized, we write to you and we give you 45 days to give us a capital restoration plan, okay? Once we agree, because you first give us your plan and we agree to it, if we don't agree to it, we ask you to change it. Once we agree to it, then you have 180 days to implement it. The first thing they did, the shareholders then immediately made available $1 million, which is about 3.8. And then they still have to bring in more to act as your buffer. Now, they can't bring in the extra because there were other things they also have to do under the capital resolution plan, which unfortunately is a confidential document. As of the end of December, they were undercapitalized. Today, as we speak, they are not undercapitalized. But there are other things which are part of the capital resolution plan, which they cannot implement because, one, there is a lockdown, and what they have so far implemented on the capital resolution plan, I think they are accounting 50%.